Hold up.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, good.
Good. How's everybody doing today?
Good.
My name is Garen. Tony is sweet that Andy is with us in spirit somewhere. But the app that we're doing is the Journey app. How we came up with the idea, we actually had what I thought was a better idea with the reverse Yelp killer, but we decided that the coding for that was a little bit too difficult, so we decided to do something a little bit more practical and something that we feel is useful and that there's not a lot of, and that's how to write your feelings or your thoughts out for the app form. How we decided to do this was back in Tony and Sweetha, and I kind of handled the front end, how it looks. We did kind of change that, so I did basic HTML for that. The new technology that we implemented was Materialize, and that is something like Bootstrap, just a little bit more advanced. It looks a little nicer. As you can see, we're still kind of playing with it a little bit. We have a little bit more to go. We didn't really get a chance to finish everything that we had originally talked about in our original groups. I'll pass the mic now to Tony just so he can talk a little bit about the back end of what was done with the journey we had.
So this particular app, I was handling authentication. So essentially the landing page, you just essentially enter in your username and password, or you click on this link to create an account. One thing about authentication is if I try, this is just a so you log in and you get to this page. Now, to make sure that if you look at it, you just get a slash journal route. To make sure that it's protected, if you just were to log out and try to be slick and think you can get in by just typing that, it should just reroute you back to the login page.
Good job.
So no matter what, you always need to have persistent session. You either create it or you create an account. So for now, let me go back. If I try to even log in without, and this is all being stored on a database, without a valid account, it now takes you to create an account page.
Cool.
What happens when you log in?
Okay, so here we are taking to the once you log in, you get this page. Here have a date, you can just enter the date being here, and here you just enter the link.
Save and then what you'll get.
Yeah, so you just save and then, we're still working on it. We actually wanted to, implement the thoughts page also, where we can, jot down our thoughts, and where we can also have like a gallery, like photos and, sometimes like videos also. So we are still working on it. So definitely time was not sufficient. So.
So a few things that we wanted to add. This journal app is specifically for yourself, right? So. You wanted to have, if you felt like sharing something on social media, you could, but that wasn't the sole premise of what we were trying to do. If you're an avid user of this particular app, we wanted a search bar somewhere like around here where you can type in maybe like, what kind of thought did I have, or what project was I working on, but I can't really remember the exact name of it. You type in a keyword, and it would bring us back into a particular thing as you wrote that particular journal entry. So as you can see, we still have a lot of work to do, but that was what we were planning on doing from the forefront, but it just didn't get done all the way. So yeah, that's pretty much all. Anybody else have anything else to say?
At the moment, basically what happens is when you enter in, so this is essentially all Materialized, CSS, this little calendar effect. Materialize comes from Google, and ironically it works best in Google Chrome. Other browsers don't seem to render well. But essentially, once you save, it is being saved to a JAWS database. And at this point, all we could do is just render it into a JSON. But from here, we can do anything with it later on. But this information is being stored in a database. So is your login. Later on, maybe possibly adding pictures, videos, and if you really want to get crazy with it, add a video log. Question?
My man.
How did you guys implement the authentication login?
Oh, just using a combination of Passport and Node Decrypt.
Okay.
It was all Node packages. It looked easy, but it wasn't.
Yeah.
Questions, comments, concerns? Nobody's concerned? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.